Hello everyone, greetings of the day. This is Komal Mathur, a legal intern at Lexis & Company and a law student at Manipal University, Jaipur. I'm proud to have this opportunity to work with Lexis & Company as a legal intern, and which is why I got this chance to present this video in front of you all. So the topic or purpose of our today's video is to discuss about cyber crimes and status of cyber law in India. So let us start with a brief introduction about cybercrime. What is cybercrime? In a nutshell, cybercrime is any illegal activity in which a computer is used as a tool, a target, or both. Traditional criminal behavior such as theft, fraud, forgery, defamation, and mischief, all of which are covered under the Indian Penal Code, might be included in the cybercrimes as well. The Information Technology Act of 2000 addresses a variety of new age offenses that have risen as a result of computer abuse. Now, cybercrime can be classified into two ways, which is first one is using computer as a target and second one is using computer as a weapon. While using computer as a target, you can the crime committers may do hacking, virus worm attacks, DOS attacks or so forth. And while using computer as a weapon, the computer can do cyber terrorism, IPR violation, credit card frauds, EFT frauds, pornography, and so on. Now, cyber law refers to legal issues surrounding the use of communication technology, particularly cyberspace, that is the internet. It is an intersection of numerous legal topics including intellectual property, privacy, freedom of expression and jurisdiction, rather than a unique field of law like property or contract. In essence, cyber law is an attempt to reconcile the issues posed by human behavior on the internet with the historical legal framework that governs physical activities. Now, what is the status of cyber law in India? When the internet was first conceived, the founders of internet had no idea that it would grow into a such big kind of, you know, field and into an all-encompassing revolution that might be used as criminal purposes as well and would also demand some control. There are a lot of disturbing things going on online these days because of the internet's anonymous character, and it is easy to participate in a wide range of criminal actions with impunity, and those with intellect have been badly utilizing these aspects of internet to perpetuate illicit operations in cyberspace. As a result, India also requires cyber law. Now, what is the importance of cyber law? Cyber law is significant because it encompasses nearly all the elements of transaction activities on and with the internet, the World Wide Web or the cyberspace. At first glance, cyber law may appear to be, you know, highly technical field with a little relevance to the ordinary cyberspace operations, but the truth on the other hand is nothing could be further from the truth. Every action and reaction in cyberspace has a certain legal and cyber legal implications whether we recognize it or not. Now, let us discuss about some cyber laws which every internet user must be aware of. The internet is similar to life, you know, it's interesting and we spend a lot of time here doing fun activities and also some, you know, official works also, students study on internet, but it always comes with its drawbacks. With the advancement of technology and widespread internet access, cybercrime has become a fairly routine event. There are numerous ways in which we might become victims of cyber criminal activities, ranging from breaking into computers to conducting fraudulent online transactions. Information Technology Act of 2000 was enacted by Indian government to restrict such acts that infringe an internet user's rights. Now, here are some of its sections that empowers an internet users and attempt to safeguard the cyberspace. First section is Section 65, which is tampering with computer source documents. Second is Section 66, using passwords of another person. Third is Section 66D, which is cheating using computer resources. Fourth is Section 66E, which is publishing private images of others. Next is Section 66F, which is acts of cyber terrorism. Another is publishing child porn or predating children online, which is Section 67. Section 69 is government's power to block websites. And Section 43A is data protection at corporate level. These are some of the common crimes being committed on daily basis. And that's all for today. We'll discuss further in next video. Have a good day. Thank you, everyone.